siriko.
I think it was 2019.
Chereka ndakoma kuweleza ku 2019.
Yeah, all of 2020 and the lockdown so. So you can see you have to be patient with God in most instances. So I'm back now. In season 3, is it season 3 or season 4?
Yeah.
That was prophetic ministry season 1 and season 2.
And then,
this is, I think, season 3. And my humble request is that everyone pays attention to understand the detail. I have been compelled to start with a new book. This is a really new book. This is the blue one is the old book. I should have gone with the content that we had already shared about. But the Holy Spirit wants me to begin afresh. And so you can bring something afresh with the old. So we shall be looking, of course, at the prophetic ministry and beginning from the roots. But before that, maybe we can prepare and pray for the word so that God can be with us. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ,
I want to
thank you once again today. We thank you. We thank you for your grace, we thank you for your mercy. We thank you for the things that you've enabled us to pass through. It shows your power. It shows your mercifulness. It shows your faithfulness. Father, we come before you because you want us to understand your word. And in fact, more importantly, the prophetic ministry. Father, we pray. May you cleanse and sanctify this word. That each and every one of us, we shall understand your word. That even I was giving the word, that I may not speak my word, by your spirit I shall speak your word. Father, I pray may you open the hearts of your people. May you open the hearts of your children. May you open their minds, Lord. And Father, they may receive this word. Because you say that as the seas cover the whole world, and also the world shall be filled with your knowledge of your word. And Father, we pray may you reveal the knowledge of this word, that we may be sanctified in the truth. We do not pray because we are holy. We pray because you are powerful and merciful, Lord. And Father, it's my prayer that through the sharing of this word, we shall all reach the fullness of our Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. May God bless you. Now, we are going back to the roots of the prophetic ministry. Just like we had shared some time ago, we are beginning afresh and looking at the prophetic ministry overview. One, we shall look at the background of the prophetic ministry. And in this, we shall look at the personalities within the prophetic ministry. Two, we shall look at the prophetic mandate. No, the mandate of faith is not a mateka. The mandate is like something to do with a vision, kind of, that, but is cemented with substance. Okay, we shall look at the prophetic mandate.
tutunuulira ebiruubirirwa ebiri mu buweereza
bw'obunnabbi
era tujja kutegeera ekinusi n'amafuta agali mu buweereza
bw'obunnabbi
era tujja kumanya obuweereza bw'obunnabbi kye ki
era
tujja kutunuulira engeri obuweereza bw'obunnabbi engeri gye butambulamu n'obuweereza
obulala
lwaki obuweereza obw'obunnabbi
number 5 we shall look at the purpose and importance of the prophetic ministry
era tujja kutunuulira omugaso n'ekigendererwa ky'obuweereza obw'obunnabbi
and in that we shall look at the greatness and the goodness of the prophetic ministry
era tujja kutunuulira obulungi n'obunene bw'obuweereza obw'obunnabbi
then we shall also look at the prophets in the prophetic ministry
era tujja kutunuulira bannabbi mu buweereza obw'obunnabbi
and then we shall look at we shall unmask Jezebel the spirit of Jezebel
era tujja kubikula ekyokyo kya Jezebelu
and then we shall look at also the prophetic authority
era tujja kutunuulira obuyinza obw'obunnabbi
then number 8 we shall look at the roles of the prophets in the prophetic ministry
era tujja kutunuulira emigaso gy'abannabbi mu buweereza obw'obunnabbi
and we shall also look at the characteristics or the features of the prophets and why do we need them
era tujja kutunuulira n'embala ez'abannabbi n'ensonga lwaki tubeetaaga
and we shall look at how do you tell this a true prophet or a false prophet
era tujja kutunuulira oyabulosha nabbi omutuufu n'omukyamu
then we shall look at the gift of prophecy
era tujja kutunuulira n'ekirabo ky'obunnabbi
we shall look at the voice of God
tujja kutunuulira eddoboozi lya Katonda
in the prophetic ministry
mu buweereza obw'obunnabbi
then we shall look at the counterfeit prophetic ministry
era tujja kutunuulira obuweereza obunnabbi obw'ekifere
yeah the prophet the false prophetic ministry normally targets wrong bullets at a wrong target
obuweereza obw'ekifere obw'obunnabbi bukasuka amasasi amafu mu kaseera akakyamu
yes exactly so we shall also look at the prophetic pitfalls
era tujja kutunuulira obunafu oba ebisuula obuweereza obw'obunnabbi
and the potholes of the prophets that they must avoid
era tujja kutunuulira n'emisanvu egiri mu buweereza obw'obunnabbi
and we shall also look at the characteristics of the counterfeit gifting
era tujja kutunuulira n'embala ez'ekirabo eky'obunnabbi ekikyamu
that sometimes you might see a gift but then it is a wrong gift
olumu oyinza okulaba ekirabo n'ate nga kirabo kikyamu
and most of the Christians fall in that category
era abalokole abasinga bagwa mu ttuluba eryo
and then we shall also look at how can we continue functioning in the prophetic ministry
era tujja kutunuulira engeri gye tutambulamu nga tweyongera mu maaso mu buweereza obw'obunnabbi
and maybe finally we shall look at the summary of the prophetic ministry
era tujja kuwumbawumba omutwe ogw'obuweereza obw'obunnabbi
now in many cases prophetic ministry has been misunderstood
kati mu biseera ebisinga obuweereza obw'obunnabbi abantu babutegeeranga
and they have misperceived it
era babutegeeranga bubi
and in fact many people think that the prophets are these people who go tell
abantu abasinga balowooza bannabbi be bano abakubuulira ebiddako mu maaso
yeah so if you are able to tell me what I ate yesterday
kati oba osobola okungamba kye nalidde ejjo
then you become thereof a prophet
awo ofuse nabbi
now that is misperception and misconception of the prophetic ministry
eyo tegeera mbi eyo obuweereza obw'obunnabbi
the prophetic ministry is quite hard and complicated and sophisticated to understand
obuweereza obw'obunnabbi buzibu era bubuzaabuza okutegeera
so by the power and the grace of God
kati ku lw'amaanyi n'ekisa ekya Katonda
we shall understand it now more again in details
tugenda kubitegeera ate ebuziba
leave out the things that we shared the other time
kati musooke muve ku biri bye twagabana luli
but we are now going to go into the detail because the other time
naye kati tugendagenda buziba kubanga luli
there's something that I could skip and thought maybe I want to tell the people about it
mulimu ebintu byenalekere nga mumanyi nti wa Katonda ajja bibagamba
but then I realized that those are the most important things that God actually wanted me to
naata namala n'enzula nti bye byali ebyomugaso nnyo bye yali ayagala mbagambe
so I was not surprised again when he said
kati seewuunya ate Katonda bwe yaŋŋamba
repeat again
nti jjangu osomesa omutwe ogwo
so we are going into the background
kati tugenda kutandikira obunnabbi gye butandikira
now let's look at the Bible itself
kati soka tunuulire Bible nga yo
this is a prophetic book
kino ekitabo kya bunnabbi
but how do we know it's a
kitabo kya bunnabbi
we must begin from Genesis and understand
tulina okutandikira mu lubeerera eby'okutegeera
most most problems in the world and in the church, they are rooted in an incorrect view and also an imbalanced view. And so the prophets are in there to bring the bigger perspective of how things can be balanced in the certain view of God. So they will consistently speak of God's love, mercy, holiness, righteousness, so that people can be founded back on the foundation of God. The prophetic ministry starts with God Himself. And how do we know that it begins with God Himself? We can go to Genesis 1. From verse 1 to 3, and maybe somebody could read for us, and I will also read in English.
Yali nyerere nga yetambudesha mundele chisikiza chani kumbulu kumuziba. Omoyo kwa Katonda ne kumamira kumbulu kumazi. Olokusatu Katonda na yogena nti wabewo obutangavu. Ne wabewo obutangavu.
God bless you. Mine reads, in the beginning God created heavens and the earth. The heavens. It's not heaven. The heavens. And the earth. The earth was void without form, and darkness was over the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Then God said, let there be light,
and
there was light. Now you can see that the world was empty. But there was an existence of the prophetic realms which were touching the waters. In fact, it was hovering. Hovering is like something which is on
top.
And that's where now where we want to understand the prophetic
realms.
Now, then God said, let there be light. And there was light. First of all, those are prophetic words. That is a prophetic utterance. So there was darkness, but then after speaking, then the light came. It is only the prophetic ministry that forms something out of nothing into something. It creates something out of nothing. So the word of God, God spoke, let there be light. That was a prophetic utterance. And it needed prophetic anointing to create. So you can see the personalities that are involved in the creation. You see the Holy Spirit hovering. You see the Word of God. And also you see God Himself speaking. But you see the anointing forming. So God spoke the word. And that is of course Jesus Christ. You've read a scripture where you see that he was involved in the creation, and the creation was created through him. That was Jesus Christ. That was
God spoke.
And it was the anointing of the prophet. Or it was the prophetic anointing that created something that was void, something that was formless, to make it more available. So there was darkness, the light came. It shows you that prophetic ministry begins with light. It cannot work where there is darkness. It has to first turn the darkness into light. Many people, you've experienced this, I don't know. You go into a certain area, you don't know anyone out there, but then you find yourself fighting with some people there. Either in a vision, either in a dream or something like that. Now it means that that area is filled with darkness. Now the anointing of the prophetic looks for where there is any evil to destroy. So you can see that there was darkness, and God said let there be light. It is only prophetic anointing that can do that. So it has been in existence from the beginning. The anointing of the prophetic did not come only with Moses, but with Elijah. The first very words of God were filled with prophetic anointing. So we can say maybe the first words from God were prophetic. And the prophetic anointing is the only anointing that creates something out of nothing. Where there is no light, it will create light. Where there is no peace, it's going to create peace. And we see that after prophetic utterance of God, and the Holy Spirit, of course, was hovering around the place, he works well with the prophetic anointing. And you cannot separate the Holy Spirit from the prophetic anointing. And if you want to see the great work of the Holy Spirit, bring the prophetic anointing. So they work hand in hand. That's why the Holy Spirit was hovering over the face of the earth to put every prophetic anointing that was spoken by God in formation. So now, the work of the prophets. No, the work of the prophet is to make the prophetic utterances, and the work of the Holy Spirit is to put the work of that word into existence. And the existence of light came because there was a prophetic utterance. So that's why we say, it is a prophetic book. It begins with prophetic anointing, and it ends with revelation, which is prophetic anointing. You can see how it is important to the church. So it's God's will that everyone understands it, because that is the backbone of it. Christianity and the church.
Kubanga, go.
It's a backbone. It's not a foundation, but it's a backbone.
Yenkizi. Obweza obobunabi. Yenkizi eri obulamu bw'omulokole yenna.
Imagine they took away your spinal cord.
Kasebelezanga nga bakujemu enkizi mu mugongo.
How do you move?
Otambula otya.
You can't move. Like you just fall. You cannot stand upright. So you can see the importance of the prophetic anointing. It's the defense, or it's the one that supports the body. So without a prophetic anointing, the
Kati
church are
watali mafuta gobu na bie kanisa tesomo la gena mas.
I have seen people who rubbish prophetic ministry.
Nabi abantu banje abaka sukedo bweleza gobu na bie.
They do not know what they are saying.
Atenga tibama inche bogera.
So we see that prophetic anointing is important from the beginning.
Katula banchino bweleza gobu na bie kwa mga sokuwa kumtandi kwa.
So the prophetic mindset begins to develop.
Kati okuchegera gobu weza gobu na bie kutandiko kula.
Much more and more finest.
Buta andiko kula obulunje nyo nyo.
With and in most rare expressions.
Na jaranga bula bisikwa mungere sara wangana ko.
During the times of apostasy.
Mukasera ko kutabura tabura.
Apostasy is when people have moved away from God.
Mukasera ko kama kasera abantu nga bavili de katonda.
That time when people are in, maybe I can say, in the crossroads, at the crossroads.
Mukasera kwa abantu nga bali mbasanga nzira.
They do not have God.
Nga tebalina Katonda.
They do not understand God.
Nga tebategeera Katonda.
They do not know where they are going.
Nga tebamanyi wa gye balaga.
They have no vision.
Nga tebalina wa kigendererwa.
They have no revelation.
Nga tebalina wa kubikulirwa.
That's when the prophetic ministry is more at its finest now.
Kati atawo obuweereza obw'obunnabbi we businga ddala okukolera.
It comes much more in rare times where people don't expect it.
Era kujja mukasera. Abantu kati babusubira.
So a prophet man will be ready and made prepared for the mantle.
Katoyo nabbi abera ngafutepo kwambale chechambalo.
And is ready to carry the burden.
Era ngamote kafo kweti kongo mugugu.
He begins to be a sign to the world.
Era tandiko kubera kaonere yensi.
And he begins pointing the church to the vision of God.
Era natandiko kutunulize kanisa eri omulama gwa Katonda.
And the vision of the kingdom.
Era nechigendera cha chowa kabaka bwa Katonda.
So the prophetic ministry normally is born.
Kato obwereza obunnabbi buzaalibwa.
Then it creates.
Ne butonda.
And then it forms.
Ate ne butondera ddala.
And it starts bringing God's perspectiveness amidst the people.
Ne butandika okuleta ebigendererwa bya Katonda mu masekati g'abantu.
And that's when it starts releasing calling and vision.
Kati atawo watandika okusumulira okuyitibwa n'ekigendererwa kye mu bantu.
So without the prophetic ministry.
Kati awataliwo obwereza obunnabbi.
I don't think many people can be called.
Sichi wantu abantu banji banyinza okuyitibwa.
Because God, when God wants to start the church.
Katonda babanga agatandike kanisa.
He first calls the prophetic anointing to support it.
Asoka kuita obwereza, asoka kuita amafuta agobunnabbi okujiwanirira.
It's only the prophetic anointing that releases calling that vision.
Amafuta agobunnabbi gakagasobola okuleta ekigendererwa n'okuyitibwa kwa Katonda.
So now that prophet in that prophetic ministry.
Kati nabbi oyo obwereza obw'obunnabbi.
He brings now the kingdom perspective now.
Ati ya sobola okuleta entegero yo kwakabaka kwa Katonda.
He begins to motivate the whole universe.
Ati ya tandika okuzamu esiyo namanyi.
And he starts to topple the government.
Kana tandika okulembera government.
No.
Natandika
to topple the government, to overthrow.
Natandika okuchusa government.
Yeah, you see many things changing within the government. The flow.
Engerije bitambula.
The kings.
Bakabaka bonna.
The church.
Amakanisa.
And all the things that have been created under perspective of God.
Ne bitubenda ebyatonde kwa mukutengera kwa Katonda.
And then he becomes the spiritual director of the church.
Nafuka omuvuzi we kanisa yomose yomoyo.
So that's why they say.
Yesonga rashi bagamba.
Pastor Israel has a vision.
Ntoba Pastor Israel inechigendererwa.
Okay, if you go to the worldly understanding of things.
Kati bogenda muntegera eyensi eyebintu.
Number these are the CEOs who normally carry the vision of companies.
Bano batera kubera ba CEO abatambula n'ekigendererwa kya company.
And in most cases they are appointed by the board of directors.
We said that ebisinga bano abakulu baabwe ba board of directors be babalonda.
And the CEO has a different way of how they can understand actually the vision of the company.
Kati ate CEO ye ebintu aba abireba bulala ebisobola okuvuga company.
So they appoint him to take the vision forward.
Kati ye bamuteekawo asobole okulera kulembera ebiruubirirwa ebyo.
So you can understand the board of directors has sat somewhere.
Kati osobola okitegeera nti nno abakulembeze ba kampani baafunako bwe baatuula.
And they said we need to appoint the CEO.
Ne bagamba twetaaga okuteekawo CEO.
Who is going to carry the vision.
Agenda okwetika ebiruubirirwa bino.
The prophet is like the CEO. That's what I'm trying to say.
Kati nabbi naye alinga CEO.
He's the one who makes the decisions.
Kati yakola okusalawo kwonna.
He's the one who plans to chase or maybe in companies.
Era yabeera n'obuyinza bwonna obugoba oba obuleeta abantu. Era asobola okusalawo n'agoba buli muntu mu kampani n'atandika n'abapya. Kubanga amateeka gamuwa obwo obuyinza bwonna.
That's how the prophet in the prophetic ministry works.
Kasine na binaye bwacho bwakula mu bwerezo bwo.
Leave alone these people who just speak whatever they don't know about outside.
Bwe bakwaba abantu abogera bye batamanye yebwe.
That I saw your husband, you're going to marry that person.
Nkinala byo bwabyo ogenda kufumbirwa oyo omusajja.
Now imagine like a CEO.
Kati tebereza CEO mulamba.
Then you go to the streets.
Ngaligoga agenda mu makube eyo.
You start telling people you see.
Mutani kagamba abantu olaba kino kiri.
People are going to see that, but this CEO they also appointed.
Bagambye nti ono CEO gwe bateekawo talina mulamwa.
So most of the prophets that you hear about out there.
Kati bannabbi b'osinga okuwulirako eyo ebweru.
They don't know anything about God's perspective.
Tebalina kye bamanyi ku nteekateeka za Katonda.
They don't have the vision of God.
Era tebalina wadde mulamwa gwa Katonda wadde.
And how do we tell?
Era tutegeera tutya?
How do we tell that this is really the spiritual director God has appointed for us?
Tutegeera tutya nti ono Katonda gwe yalonda atukulembere?
His vision is contemplative vision.
Ekigendererwa kye kiba nga kyalowoolezebwako dda.
Which is a revolutionary vision.
Ate nga kijja n'enkyukakyuka.
Exactly, it comes with changes.
Era kijja n'enkyukakyuka.
If you see a vision does not make any changes.
Kati bw'olaba ng'olinya alina omulamwa naye nga tegulina nkyukakyuka.
It does not bring. Take all the comfortability of the people and bring something new.
Ateka tekireta chintu chipya mu maso gabantu.
And it wasn't a contemplative vision.
Ogwo mulaba kubate baagulowooza kuba ne nogu planningira.
These visions bring practical unity of the spirit.
Gino emiramwa gireta enkyukakyuka eragwako mu mubiri ne mu mwoyo.
You're able to see things in reality.
Osobola okulaba ebintu mu buliwo.
You're able to understand things with the spirit.
Osobola okulaba ebintu n'omwoyo.
You're able to understand things.
Osobola okutegeera ebintu.
In the way they are meant to be.
Mu ngeri gye birina okubeera.
Things come to pass.
Era ebintu ne bimala ne bituukirira.
That is the practical way.
Kati yeyo engeri eragwako.
So the prophet.
Omunabbi
is the spiritual director
yabeera omukulembeze w'omwoyo
pointing the universe
era nga atunuuliza ensi
or the church of God
oba ekkanisa ya Katonda
the initial vision of God
mu kiruubirirwa kya Katonda ekyasooka
from the beginning
okuva mu ntandikwa.
You know, from the beginning things went a bit aside.
Mumanyi okuva mu ntandikwa ebintu byasobamu.
Because the humans misbehaved and then they gave up authority.
Kubanga abantu baayonoona ne wabaayo obuyinza bwabwe.
Now, the authority of course was brought back by Jesus Christ.
Obuyinza bwakomezaawo Yesu Kristo.
Now, that authority need to work.
Kati ate obuyinza obwo bulina okukola.
But this time it has its spiritual director.
Naye kati mu kaseera kano bulina abukulembera.
Let me give you one story.
Kambaweeko olugero lumu.
It's kind of a story but then it's a true testimony.
Naye ate nga bujulizi butuufu.
I had not yet come here.
Nali sinajja wano.
I didn't know this place.
Nali simanyi kifo kino.
I didn't know anyone here.
Nali sinago nali mmanyi wano.
I was not even a saved person.
Ate nze nali sina mulokole.
It was in 2012.
Yali 2012.
One time
lumu
I was at home.
Nali waka.
I got a vision.
Nafuna okwolesebwa.
There was a shepherd.
Waliwo omulunzi.
Okay, they brought like a TV before me.
Kale nze bandeeteranga TV mu maaso gange.
So I saw a shepherd that just like the way you watch on a TV.
Kati nendaba omulunzi nga gwe wolaba TV.
He was an old man.
Yali musajja muzeeyi.
So he had the flock were following him.
Yalina ekisibo nga kimugoberera.
Now, I wondered because I didn't know these things.
Kati neneewuunya ne ngamba oba kino kiki.
No, now the voice was telling me.
Kati eddoboozi ne liŋŋamba.
You see this old man here?
Nti olaba n'omusajja omuzeeyi.
He's alone there.
Ali yekka.
He's trying to lead the flock to where I want that flock to be.
Aligezako kutwala ekisibo gye njagala akitwale.
I want you to join that particular old man.
Nate njagala nawe wegatteko kw'oyo omusajja omuzeeyo.
I didn't know that old man.
Nze nali simanyi musajja muzeeyo.
I didn't know anything to do with actually pastorship.
Nze nali sina kye mmanyi oba kubya busumba oba byaki nali sina kye mmanyi.
So after I think after 1 year.
Kati nga wayiseewo omwaka.
1 year or 2 years.
Nga obanga emyaka ebiri.
So I came to this place.
Ne nzija mu kifo kino.
I came up there.
Nagenda wali waggulu.
But remember,
jukira.
This was 20. I had even somehow forgotten about whatever was going on.
Nze nali nabyera bya nabi abigenda maso.
So when I reached there,
when natuka yeyo,
I found some pastors around.
Nesanga abasumba abamu.
I think there was also Pastor Mukisa around.
Cheka waliwo ne Pastor Mukisa.
Pastor Israel and some other.
Ne Pastor Israel n'abalala awo.
People, I was in Mukono that day.
Nze nali mu Mukono mu kaseera.
And the hospital told me you should look for Pastor Israel.
Omwo mchukuvu nangamba agenda ononye Pastor Israel.
So one time,
Kachilumu,
there is a lady I met, like I used to meet with her.
Waliwo muchala kwenda sisi inkana.
I didn't tell me about that Pastor Israel.
Kati nabeerawo nga angamba ku Pastor Israel.
So I was in Mukono, actually I was doing surveys.
Kati nze nali mu Mukono nga ndabye nnoonyereza.
That day I was compelled to come.
Naye akaseera ako nali wayizibwa okujja.
So I came around Tosha, so someone came.
Nenzijawo ku Tosha na wawajja nankima.
Now when I sat there,
kati ali bwe natuula.
I think he was praying for someone. Then there was Pastor Mukisa around here.
Waliwo Pastor Mukisa naye.
So Pastor Mukisa was like, I know you.
At Pastor Mukisa nagamba gwe kumanyi.
Started seeing these are fairy now.
Ashinagamba kati bano ba fairy kanziruke.
How does he know me?
Amanyi atya.
So he asked me, so who is you? Are you from a church?
Ati namuuza kuva mu kanisa ki? Nze ne mugamba nti nze nzize wano.
They told me about this particular old man I want to.
Nze waliwo omusajja omuzeeyi gwe bangambye.
Then he was like, so where do you worship from?
Kati namuuza gwe osinziza wa.
I don't go for worship, but then there is someone I used to go to.
Nze ne mugamba nti nze sisinza naye nze wabangawo gwe nalabanga nga nkyali muto.
He said, I know that person is very good.
Nagamba nti nze oyo mumanyi mulungi.
Means I should go back now.
Kati mumchima nengama ati ekitegeza kankanve wano.
So I was a bit now this is the old man I'm looking for.
Kati mumchima ngamba tolo musajja mukadde gwe nnoonya.
Now when I reached okay that day passed.
Kati onakulo neruita.
I finally met with him.
Namera nemusisinka na.
I was like I'm the one.
Nemugamba yenze.
So I went back home.
Kati nenzira yeka.
Now when I went back home.
Bwe natuuka eka.
I prayed.
Nensaba.
So God brought me another vision.
Kati Katonda n'adeetera okwolesebwa okulala era n'okulinga TV.
Now he brought Pastor Israel.
Nandeetera Pastor Israel.
Of course we. He was the old man.
Era yalo msanjo mkadde.
Remember this was around 2012.
Yalinga 2012.
I didn't know about this place.
Zanalisi mani chipo chino.
I didn't know anybody here.
Yalanga sana mtu kwe mbali wano.
Now he brought him.
Yamuleta.
And I was like, let me go and visit him.
Nengamba kangene mucharire.
So I found myself visiting him.
Atende nesanga ngandiko mucharire.
So I found him in a certain plantation.
Kati nze namusanga omusiri ogumu.
So he was trying to get the banana.
Nga aliko agezako okuggyayo amatooke.
I greeted him.
Ne mubuuza.
He's like, you come, there's something I want to show you.
Kati nampita nagamba gwe jangu nakyo njagala okulaga.
Let's go where I stay.
Tugende wa gye mbeera.
So I went to his place.
Ne ngenda mu ewuwe.
I found he was sleeping in anointing.
Kati ne musanga nga yeko yebase mu mafuta.
The tankers of anointing everywhere.
Nga tanka ziri buli wangu zonna.
He had nowhere actually to sleep but the whole house was.
Nga tanka na wakwe bakanga nyumba yonna ejjudde tanka za mafuta.
So of course I didn't understand.
Nge saa mtegeera.
So I asked now.
Kati ne mbuuza.
What does this mean?
Kati kino kitegeeza ki?
That is the prophetic anointing that you must go and flow. This was around 20, I think it was 2013.
Kati wano yalinga
2013-2014 there.
2014-2014.
These are old things.
So
and that's why now I testify the prophetic
anointing.
I know what it has to take.
Yes. kitwalira.
And I know what it carries now.
Era mmanyi kiki ekyetikka.
And where it is taking the whole church.
Era ne wekitwala ekkanisa.
So you can see that the prophetic anointing is a bit illustrative.
Katosobola okulaba nti obuweereza obw'obunnabbi bw'obulabwako.
So I can greatly confirm.
Era kati nsobola okukakasa nti
this ministry is true and full.
Nti buno obuweereza butuuka ate bujjuvu.
I don't think I would have come back.
Sikiwanti oba nandikomyewo.
But I think God knows why.
Naye nkimanyi Katonda amanyi lwaki.
But due to what I saw so many things, just some of them I can't share with you.
But nalaba ebintu bingi lwakubanga ebisinga sobola biga bana nange.
Now, the reason why I came here.
Ensonga lwaki najja wano.
How will I flow in that prophetic anointing?
Nti nakulukuta ntya mwaga amafuta g'obunnabbi.
Because I have seen how it is.
Kubanga ngalabyeko.
I have never shared actually much of this. But that's how now I've come to understand. Oh, this is what God meant.
You need to understand
the prophetic ministry.
So that you can be
able to flow in it.
So the prophetic
anointing is really substantial.
Kati amafuta ag'obunnabbi ga mugaso nnyo nnyo.
Let's read in Jeremiah 23.
Tusome Jeremiah 23
from 16:23. We want to understand.
Okuva ku 16:23.
From 16:23.
Okuva ku 16:23 mpaka ku 23.
Bwati bwayogera Mukama ow'Eggye nti, temuliranga bigambo bya bannabbi ababalabula. Babayigiriza ebitaliiko kye bigasa. Boogera okwolesebwa okuvudde mu mitima gyabwe bosso obutavudde mu kamwa ka Mukama. 17. Bagamba olutataabo abanyooma nti, Mukama ayogedde, timuli ba mirembe, na buli muntu atambulira mu bukakanyavu bw'omutima gwe, ye bamugamba nti, tewali ba bubi obuli bajjira. 18. Kubanga ani eyali ayimiridde Mukama w'ateeseza ebigambo ategeera awulira ekigambo kye? Ani yali yeetegereza ekigambo kyange n'akiwulira? Laba, kibuyaga wa Mukama kye kibi kye, afulumye weewaawo kibuyaga wa kazimu aligwa ku mutwe gw'ababi. 20. Obusungu bwa Mukama tebulidda okutuusa lw'alimala okutuukiriza okutuusa lw'alikomekkereza omutima gwe bye gumaliridde mu nnaku ez'oluvannyuma, mulikitegeera ddala. 21. Saatuma bannabbi bano naye ne badduka nambiro, saayogera nabo naye ne balagula. 22. Naye singa bayimirira mu kuteesa kwange, kale bandiwuliza abantu bange ebigambo byange, era bandibakyusizza okuleka ekkubo lyabwe ebbi n'obubi obw'ebikolwa byabwe. 23. Nze ndi Katonda ali okumpi, bw'ayogera Mukama. So siri Katonda ali ewala?
Yeah, God bless you.
Nakuomukisa.
This is God speaking.
Katonda yayogera.
He says.
Agamba.
No, it was Jeremiah.
Thus
says the Lord,
of course,
do not listen to the words of the prophets who prophesy to you. They make you worthless. They speak a vision of their own heart. Now, we are understanding how we tell that this is really a vision from God, from the prophet.
Kati tuliko tutegeera nti kuno obwolesebwa kuva wa Katonda oba nedda.
Remember we have said.
Mujjukire nti tugambye.
That a prophetic mindset develops into its finest.
Nti endowooza y'obunnabbi ekuyira ddala mu bulungi bwayo.
With most rare expressions.
Nga ezze mu ndabisibwa etamanyiddwa.
During the days of apostasy.
Mu kaseera ak'okutabulatabula nga abantu bavudde Katonda.
And we said that the vision of the prophet.
Era ne tugamba nti omulamwa gwa nnabbi
points that the church to the vision of the kingdom.
Gutunuliza ekkanisa eri obwakabaka bwa Katonda.
Now, this is where we have to understand. We are still in the background.
Kati wano bwe tulina okutegeera naye lwakuba wali tukyali mu ntandikwa.
So now, God is saying that they speak from their own heart.
Katonda alikaga matindo bobo okeranga biva ku mitima gyabwe.
And therefore they make you more worthless.
Era ne bakuwetera okubanga togasiza ddala.
You can see the substance.
If
in the prophetic word or in the prophetic ministry,
there
is no substance of God,
there is no
substance of the Holy Spirit,
there is
no substance of the true word.
Everyone
they speak to, they make you more worthless than
you.
You become like senseless.
Era obanga toyina magezi.
You become every wind takes you.
Era na buli muyaga gukutwala butwazi.
The word worthless.
Ekigambo okubanga toyina mugaso wadde.
It is a very bad word actually to use to do as a person.
Ekyo ekigambo kibi nnyo nnyo okikozesa ng'ekigambo.
Look at this worthless person.
Omuntu bw'agamba laba nnono talina mugaso talimu wadde kintu kyonna.
Kiba
kitegeeza oli musirusiru nnyo
totegeera
tolina mulamwa tolina mugaso
temulimu
kintu ku ggwe kye tuyinza kukufunamu
kati
bw'obanga oyagala kulaba omuntu alina omulamwa ogutunuulidde Katonda ebigambo byabwe bikuleetera okubeera ow'omugaso ekigendererwa kyabwe kikutunuuliza obwakabaka bwa Katonda.
You do not become useless.
Tobeerawo nga tolina mugaso.
You do not become worthless.
Tobeerawo nga tolina mulamwa.
Now, why does God say that?
Kati lwaki Katonda agamba.
I wish they had stood in my counsel.
Nti kale singa bayimirira mu kubuulirirwa kwange.
They would have proclaimed my word.
Banjogedde ekigambo kyange.
And then they would have turned the people from their evil heart.
Era banikyusiza abantu okuva mu mitima gyabwe emikyamu.
And make them people who are useful.
Era ne bafuula abantu ab'omugaso.
God is trying to tell us something here.
Katonda alikagezaako tugambe ekintu wano.
That when he has appointed a prophet,
nti bw'abanga alonze nabbi
to carry a vision of the kingdom,
okwetikka omulamwa ogw'obwakabaka bwe,
his work is to point the people to the vision.
Omulimu gwe gwa kutunuza abantu ku mulamwa gwa Katonda.
And when the people get pointed to that vision,
era abantu bwe batunuza mu kigendererwa kya Katonda,
begin to understand who God is.
Bajja kutandika okutegeera Katonda kyali.
They will understand what we are about.
Bajja kutandika okutegeera n'ekyabaleeta.
They will become a benefit to the society.
Era bajja kufuuka omugaso eri ekitundu kyonna.
And now you can confirm.
Kati osobola okakasa nti.
That God said, bring my people to understand me.
Nti leeta abantu bange bantegeere.
Somebody would say maybe they have to kill these people so that they can understand.
Mutaizo uloza chileka ndakuwa wano chivoko kutegera Katonda.
But the work is to point the people to the vision of the kingdom.
Na
yate
uko umulimuguli kutunuza abantu eliyo mulamwa gwa Katonda.
And the reason is that he's standing in the council of God.
Ensonga eri nti ayimiridde mu kubuulirirwa kwa Katonda.
If they had stood in my council,
era singa bayimirira mu kubuulirirwa kwange,
they would have turned my people from the evil ways.
Banikyusiza abantu okuva mu neeyisa embi.
So when the prophet in the prophetic ministry,
kati nabbi mu buweereza obw'obunabbi,
understands the vision of God,
bw'ategeera omulamwa gwa Katonda,
and therefore stands in the counsel of the Lord,
era n'ayimirira mu kubeerawo kwa Katonda,
he will turn many people into the vision of God,
era ajja kukyusa abantu bangi abateeke omulamwa gwa Katonda,
and his anointing is going to release calling and vision.
Era n'amafuta ge gajja kusumululawo okuyitibwa n'ebigendererwa bya Katonda mu bantu.
And you begin to understand who you are.
Era ojja kutandika okwetegeera gwani mu maaso ga Katonda.
That's how you understand that I am a prophet. Ojja
kutegeera nti nze ndi nabbi, ndi musomesa, ndi musumba.
The reason is that there is a vision that I don't know, it overflows.
Ensonga wali nti waliwo omulamwa era ogukulukutira mu mafuta g'obunnabbi.
So God speaks prophetically.
Katonda ayogera mu bunnabbi.
And therefore we must also get prepared to understand him that way.
Era naffe tulina okwetegeka okutegeera engeri gy'ayogeramu.
And also in Genesis 3:15 he said.
Era mu Luberyeberye 3:15 yagamba.
This was after the fall.
Nga omwana w'omuntu amaze okwonoona.
He said, I'll put an enemy between you and the woman.
Era yagamba nti nja kuteekawo omulabe mu masekkati g'omusajja n'omukyala.
Between your offspring. offspring, and her offspring, he shall bruise you, and you shall also bruise his heel. Now, this was a prophetic message from God, which was calling for judgment and salvation. It was speaking about the church rivalry against the dark world, and it was meant also to be a burden for the prophetic. And that's why you see, like the background of the prophetic ministry is released by the power of God to create judgment and salvation. So you cannot separate salvation and judgment from the prophetic
ministry.
What is about actual prophetic anointing boys? You are either judged or you are saved. And if you are judged, therefore you are either cast. So a word of judgment in a prophetic anointing, it can be a word of salvation to you when you embrace it. A word of salvation to you in the prophetic anointing, it can turn into a judgment if you fail to embrace it. The prophetic ministry stands on the two pillars. The word of judgment can be a word of salvation to you if you embrace it. For example, now it can be like, say, these people do this, these people do this. Now, if you don't take that judgment word into an offense, and you say, hey, good, am I one of them? Now it turns into a word of salvation. Now, prophetic anointing dwells on two words, dwells on two pillars. The prophetic anointing stands on two pillars, which is judgment and salvation. It's either salvation or it is judgment. And for salvation, it has a lot. We cannot even speak about much more about it. There is creation, there is salvation, there is conversion, in the salvation. And in judgment also, there is a lot. You know, there is a judgment which can be rightful judgment, and there is a judgment that leads to your blessing. But there is a judgment that leads to your cursing. So we break judgment. There is a blessing and also there is a curse within the judgment. And for salvation, it is a lot. Somebody maybe in the future will teach about salvation. So all these prophetic utterances that we see from the creation, and also God saying that I will create an enmity between the woman and then maybe the devil and so forth, all of them were being carried to be a burden to the coming prophet. So like we said, that a word of judgment can be salvation to those who believe it. And also, a word of salvation can be the judgment to those who misuse it. The prophetic voice, it releases power
lisumulula amaani
of God to work on earth
aga Katonda okola mu nsi
to bring either salvation
okuleta obulokozi
and to bring either judgment
oba okuleta okusala omusango
and we see one of the great prophets in the Bible
era tulaba omu banabbi abanene mu Bible
Enoch the prophet
Enoch nabbi
so we can read about him in Jude
tusobola okumusoma mu kitabo kya Jude
Jude 1:14-15 because I want to confirm
to
why judgment and salvation in the prophetic ministry
njagala balaga engeri okusala omusango n'obulokozi bw'obikolamu mu buweereza bw'obunnabbi
it's one chapter
Jude
chapter 1 from 14 to 15
Era abo yabalagulako Enoch omusanvu okuva ku Adamu ng'ayogera nti laba Mukama yajja n'abatukuvu be kakumi olw'ekumi n'ettaano okuleeta omusango bonna n'okusinza omusango bonna abatatya Katonda olw'ebikolwa byabwe byonna bye bakoledde obutatya Katonda n'olw'ebigambo byabwe byonna ebikakanyavu abonoonyi abatatya Katonda bye bamwogeddeko.
Thank you. Now, let me read mine in English. It says, Now Enoch, the seventh from Adam,
kati Enoch owokubiri okuva mu Adam,
prophesied about the men also saying, Behold, the Lord comes with 10,000 of his saints.
Yalagula eri abo abagamba ng'agamba nti nno laba Katonda ajja n'akakumi akabatuukirivu.
To execute judgment on all.
Okuleeta okusala omusango ku bonna.
To convict all who are ungodly among them.
Era okulumiriza abo abatali batuukirivu mu bo.
And all of their ungodly deeds which they have done and committed in ungodly way.
Era bonna bonna abakola ebikolwa byonna ebitali bya butuukirivu.
And of all the harsh things which ungodly sinners have spoken.
Era nabo bonna bonna ebibi bye baayogera eri ye.
These are the words of Enoch a long time ago.
Bye bino ebigambo bya Enoch ebbanga emabega ennyo nnyo.
He was speaking about salvation and judgment.
Yali ayogera ku kulokolebwa n'okusala omusango.
He said, Behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000 of his saints. That's salvation.
Yagamba Katonda aleka ajja n'akakumi ke akabatukuvu.
At the same time,
naacha mukasera ke kamu
execute judgment.
Okuleta okusala omusango.
So you can see that the prophetic ministry turns on the two pillars.
Noza olaba obwezo bw'obunabi bwimira ku mpaji bbiri.
It's about salvation and judgment.
Biri mu kulokolebwa n'okusalirwa omusango.
If you're in the prophetic ministry,
kati bw'obanga oli mu bwezo bw'obunabi,
you must be very careful.
Olokubeera obwegendereza.
You are either judged or you're saved.
Bajja okusalirwa omusango oba ojja kulokolebwa.
I don't say that Pastor Isaiah is coming to therefore give you a judgment.
Toga machino Pastor Isaiah agenda kuja wana tandiko kusalira omusango.
The prophetic ministry itself.
Obweza bo munabi bo nyini nyini.
The moment you begin the prophetic ministry.
Bo tani ko obweza bo munabi.
You either have entered your salvation.
Ojaba o yingi do blokozi go.
Oh you have entered your judgment. So
bo yingi do kusalira omusango kati gwasalawo.
So it is it choose either judgment or salvation.
Bo kusalira okusalira omusango obo kulokolebwa.
So you can either turn the judgment into salvation.
Kati osobola okufula okusalira omusango obulokozi go.
Do you know that before we come into salvation we are all judged?
Washimashino kata tuna jambo bulokozi fenda tubera twasa ya demisango.
Then when you come now God turns the judgment into salvation.
Atabwa malo okuloka kakatonda na fulo musango go bulokozi ngo.
You get the point.
Muchitegera.
So basically and this was prophesied long time ago.
Kati shino chala kulibwa damu bisera byedda.
So we are still in the background to understand how this prophetic anointing comes to work with us to come in the church.
Tushali ko tutandika kutali singa tutegera ngira obweleza bwo munabbi je kukola.
How does it get pointed to other ministries? How does it get
Kati ate kukola kuchano obweleza obulala.
So we can say of course that like we said
tusobola okugamba nti
that Enoch worked as a spokesman for God on earth
nti Enoch yakola ng'omwogezi wa Katonda ku nsi
and his prophetic message released the power of God
era n'obubaka bwe obunabbi bwasumulula amaanyi ga Katonda
to plan for the salvation
okuplaningira obulokozi ku nsi obwabatukuvu era n'okuleeta okusala omusango eri buli omu lwaki kino okuva mu ntandikwa omwana w'omuntu bwe yayonoona n'ava mu kkubo lya Katonda bawaayo obuyinza bwabwe ebiseera ebyo kyabanga kizibu nnyo Katonda okutabagana n'ensi
And that's why the Spirit of God was lost and God had to appoint people to put his Spirit so that he can speak.
No, kwayo wakatonda na yeye aliyavako na katikatonda ndio kufuna abantu batekawo asobole kuteka mu moyo we.
Yeah, to have the influence on earth.
Asobole okubako na echa kola munsi.
For instance, the prophets are the influencers on earth.
Banabi bebalechera katonda okola munsi.
So their prophetic utterances, their prophetic anointing makes or breaks the power of God on earth to act.
Byawe byobunabbi byebireetera Katonda okujja okukola ku nsi
because God is faithful to the word
kubanga Katonda mwesimbu eri ekigambo
kye so if the word is spoken he
follows ekigambo bwe kyogerwa akigoberera
so it gives the power of God to come and act on earth
kati kiwa amaanyi ga Katonda okukanyaga kola ku nsi
now without the prophetic anointing
kati awatali mafuta g'obunabbi
the church becomes a playground for the enemy
ekkanisa efuuka ekisaawe ky'obulabe
and without the prophetic anointing
kati atawatali mafuta g'obunabbi
the church lacks intensity of flow of communication between our fifth manifestation and heavens
ekkanisa ebura engeri omwomutukuvu gy'akulukutamu okukola mu bantu be ne Katonda
You see how now we start pointing into the church.
Ndozabula bengi yatanso kuchitunuze kanisa.
Now, the prophetic anointing of course forms.
Mafuta ago unabigatonda.
The one that forms the giftings, the one that continue to make.
Ge galeta ebirabo ge kapuze ebirabo.
Now, without the prophetic anointing,
kacha watali mafuta ago unabi.
Most of the gifts are retarded.
Ebirabo ebisinga bifa.
And the communication cannot overflow.
Era n'empuliziganya tesobola kutambula bulungi.
So basically it is like a connectivity between here and heaven.
Kati kulinga ebanga line nga olaba line y'essimu mu makati g'eggulu ne wano ku nsi.
So when God is speaking or God wants to do any work,
kati Katonda bw'abanga ayogera ngaliko kyonna ky'ayagala okukola.
That's why he first seeks to reach the prophets.
Asooka kutuukirira bannabbi.
Why doesn't he go to the pastors first?
Because atwashi tagenda kubasumba.
Why doesn't he come to the teachers and
say, atwashi tagenda kubasomesa okusooka.
Ah, there is something I want to do.
Naga manchi waliwo kyenjagala okukola.
Because they do not have that prophetic anointing.
Kubanga tebalina mafuta ga bunnabbi ago.
To release the power of God to work there.
Okuleetera amaanyi ga Katonda okukola.
To form things which are nothing into something to form
again. Okutonda ebintu n'abifuula ebyomugaso ebibadde bitali.
So when he first calls the prophet.
Kati Katonda bw'abanga ajja asooka kuyitira mu bannabbi.
No, when he's about to call people.
Kati ate n'owabanga anaatera okuyita abantu asooka kugambako bannabbi.
You can see all these instances in the Bible.
Bino bino byonna tubiraba mu Bayibuli.
You can see how he called Enoch.
Tulaba engeri gye yayita Enoch.
You can see how he met with Moses.
Tulaba engeri gye yasisinkana ne Musa.
You can see how he brought John the Baptist.
Tulaba engeri gye yaleeta Yokana Omubatiza.
You can see how he walked with Elijah.
Tulaba engeri gye yatambula ne Elijah.
So like because their work is to point the people to the vision of God.
Kubanga emirimu gyabwe gya kuleetera abantu kutunuulira mulamwa gwa Katonda n'obwakabaka bwe.
So that's how we bring the prophetic message into perspective of God.
Kati bwetu ky'obwenyi tuletera obuweereza obw'obunnabbi mu bantu.
We also have Moses, one of them, who said,
Katuina Musa omukuboya gamba.
Being the prophet of God continued to confirm.
Yeke nyino okubera nabbi wa Katonda yagenda maso nga akakasa.
We can read in Deuteronomy 18.
Tusobola okusoma
15 to 18. Deuteronomy 18, 15 to 18.
Deuteronomy ekyamateeka 18 okuva ku 15 paka 18
Mukama Katonda wo alikuyimusiza nabbi wakati wo kubanga go afaanana nga nze oyo gw'owuliwulira 16 nga byonna bwe byali bye wasaba Mukama Katonda wo kukolebu kunako olw'okukuŋŋaanirako ng'oyogera nti nneme okuwulira nate eddoboozi lya Mukama Katonda wange era nneme okulaba nate omuliro guno omungi nneme okufa 17 Mukama n'aŋŋamba nti boogedde bulungi ebyo bye bagambye ndi wayimusiza nnabbi ku baganda baabwe afaanana nga ggwe era nditeeka ebigambo byange mu kamwa ke era alibabuulira byonna bye ndimulagira.
God bless you. So now this is Moses, he says, that the Lord your God will raise up a prophet like me from amidst you, from your brethren, him you shall hear, that according to all the desired, the Lord your God in Horeb, of the day assembly saying,
agamba nti,
I think these people were complaining on the Mount Horeb about God.
Kireka bana bantu baliko nga beemulugunya ku lusozi Horeb.
And so God promised these people,
Katonda n'asuubiza bana bantu,
that he's going to raise a prophet like Moses.
Nti agenda bayimusiza nabbi nga Musa.
Who is going to be, okay, he's going to proclaim the name of the Lord.
Agenda okwogera erinnya lya Katonda era aleetera abantu okubeera ku mulamwa gwa Katonda.
But he is speaking to Moses.
Naye atandika ayogera ne Musa.
So Moses was confirming what from the beginning.
Kati Musa yaliko nga akakasa ebyo ebyaliwo okuva ku ntandikwa.
And these words were proclaimed about Jesus Christ the Messiah.
Era bino ebigambo byali byogera ku Yesu Kristo.
And many people misunderstood what Moses said.
Era abantu abasinga tebategeera Musa kye yayogera.
Because these were prophetic utterances.
Kubanga bino byali bigambo bya munnabbi.
That in Jesus,
nti mu Yesu Kristo,
they will hear and listen.
Bali wulira era bategeere.
And so it is the time now.
Era ke kaseera kano.
That you shall hear.
Nti ojja kuwulira.
You listen.
Era otegeere.
And you understand.
Era otegeere ddala.
So we can see that God always confirms his message through the prophets.
Tulaba nti no Katonda atera nnyo kakasa obubaka bwe ng'ayise mu bannabbi.
That their prophetic utterances are never understood. People misunderstand them.
Nti ebigambo by'obunnabbi byo si bizibu kutegeera naye abantu bwe babitegeera obubi.
Like for example, sometimes Pastor Israel maybe can speak something here.
Kati olumu Pastor Israel ayinza okwogera ekigambo wano.
And it's a prophetic word.
Ate nga kigambo kya munnabbi.
And you do not understand it.
Ne mutakitegeera.
For you, you're used to this prophet.
Kati mwe mwamanyira bannabbi we bati.
Who comes and calls you,
Ajja n'akugamba kati gwe gundi jangu.
You make a line.
Kati nawe simba line.
Put your money there.
Gweteeka wano ssente zo.
Let me proclaim to you the words of the Lord.
Leka mbeeko kyenkulagula ekiva eri Katonda.
And it starts divining.
Katadana atandika okulagula.
But the true prophets that we see,
naye ate nabbi omutuufu gwe tulaba,
they make prophetic utterances,
bakola ebigambo eby'obunnabbi,
that are rarely understood,
ate nga olumu abantu tebatera kubitegeera,
but God understands them,
naye ate nga Katonda yabitegeera,
and they come to pass,
ate nebimala nebituukirira.
You've seen.
Mulabye.
Okay, let me just remind you a little bit. Just here in this place.
Kale kambeko sheba juki za chitini wano mchine chifo.
So many people are praying for this building.
Abasinga mpato wa kamusa mida chine chizime.
God must take this place.
Kuna chine chifo, chino chitwala.
I don't know, I know you prayed.
Nchimani mwasa haba.
Even some of you were very disappointed, hi, isn't it?
Achemwe abasinga mwabali wa mwamani.
But you remember Pastor Israel, even during that controversies.
Ndo za mochi kila Pastor Israel chayogira mkasela kakwa kutabura tabura.
Was like, actually we need to make a way down there.
Mungu kila yagama
tikale kwa tepo. They are not even the building this place here.
Matuna kuchani kakuzimba wa nana matikale tuino kufunde kuwa lietu tekao.
Yeah, I think also we shall make a gate somewhere there.
Yani tukama watu wao na
make
a gate.
He wanted it to be done as soon as possible.
Era yale ayagala chikolebwe mangu.
But I think people are a bit reluctant.
Naye chaika abantu bali banafuna fu.
But he was trying to mean that this place is not for now.
Naye yaliko nga ategeza chine chifo sisi cha kakati.
Let's focus on what we have.
Nti tutunuire chino chetulina.
But people did not understand.
Naye abantu bashitegeera.
And people continued to pray.
Ne basigala nga basaba.
I remember Chalasari was saying, you come.
Yeah,
she comes in. we need to go and even sleep at the church.
That
for me, I knew.
Then Namanya.
I said,
nze nalinga nawulidde pastor Israel kye yayogera.
Era
nagamba tutereke eryo ekkubo lya wansi
awo. Era
abantu baliko nga basaba n'ekkanisa ekyaliko awo.
Now you see, for you you're waiting for someone come and I proclaim to you the word of the Lord.
Mwe muli awo mulinze muntu kuyita kumala kulagulako.
He will speak utterances that are a bit sophisticated, but
era ajja kwogera ebigambo eby'obunnabbi nga biringa eby'olusaago era bimala ne bituukirira.
When we went into the lockdown, you saw what happened now.
Era bwe twagenda mu lockdown mwalaba ekyabaawo.
The building was put. Very first year, everything was closed, I think.
Ekizimbe baakizimba mangu, buli kifune bakiggala mangu.
And now he was saying,
era ng'agamba nti nagamba abantu bano.
If they had, you know, listened to what I had said from
the... Sinabawulira kye nabagamba.
So, you understand? So, what I'm trying to say that...
Kyendezaako okugamba nkiri nti...
In the background, when you want to understand the prophet...
Nti oyinza obutategeera bannabbi eno.
You must pay much attention to their words, what
they speak. Oyina okubeera omwegendereza nnyo ku bigambo bye boogera.
Otherwise, you're going to miss the message of God.
Kubanga ojja kukomekereza ng'osubidde obubaka bwa Katonda.
And you keep making pointless prayers.
Ate gwe n'osigala ng'okola essaala ezitali mu makulu.
You pray, you even fast.
Ojja kusaba osiibe n'okusiiba.
Get already God decided long time ago. So we need to understand that Moses was misunderstood. And it was one of the factors why people delayed in the desert. They delayed in the desert because they
don't
understand what God had done to people. And it's another reason why Jesus Christ has even... We have
played
the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But because we are not understanding the prophetic message, we are not understanding the vision that God is pointing to us. For you
are
waiting for God to come and say, therefore my church, I have given you that place.
Goliza wakatonda jaga ambe kane bawande chifecho.
And you shall take it.
Ena na mamuja chitwala.
Yeah, that's what they are saying.
Kana je muri muno obubako obujja bwe bucho.
Yeah, so in most cases these are some of the things that we do not understand.
Kati mu bisere bisinga byone ebimu ku bintu ebitategeera.
And we fail to understand the background and why we need the prophet.
Ne tulemera okutegeera ensonga lwaki twetaaga obuweereza bw'obunnabbi.
Now let's look at the prophetic mandate. I was giving you a little bit about the background to understand what prophetic anointing means and why we need to relate with it.
But then the koi mbawako obweleza bw'obunnabbi kye butegeeza ne kibeeramu.
I think I'm left with a few minutes.
Ndoza sikaze dakika ntini nnyo.
But let me unleash the prophetic mandate so that you may understand.
Leka tutunulire ekiruubirirwa ky'obweleza bw'obunnabbi.
Now, the prophetic mandate is this. The burden of the prophetic ministry is to bring the things of heaven bare on earth, to enforce the authority of eternal word over the temporal, with the view of transforming the earthly to become like heavenly. The things of the earth must transform to be like the heavenly. Now, the mandate also is that before we transform the earthly into the heavenly, we must first lose our love for the
earthly.
And this is where we find the biggest burden of the prophet. Now, the earthly don't want to to lose their earthly love.
Kati banabensi tebagala kusula bintu byabwe byansi.
They want to be with it.
Bagala kusigaza okwagala kwabwe okwensi.
But at the same time they want to be like the heaven.
Ati ate nga bagala okubeera nga ab'eggulu.
You see the problem.
The
mandate is the mandate of the prophetic ministry. Let me repeat it because you need to understand. The true prophetic ministry mandate is to bring the heavens bare on earth. Basically, just like the way you see. You know, but I get the visions. They are bringing the heavenly to come and bear. So that you start getting familiar with them. That is one of the mandates of the prophetic ministry. To enforce authority of eternal
world.
Over a temporal. Or what is the earth? With the view of transforming the earth to become like
heaven.
Like basically now let's look at the Christian life. Like his mandate, okay, his mandate or maybe his will.
Okwagala kwa Katonda
is to transform you from the earthly view.
Abayagala akuchuse mu mbala n'embeera eyensi.
To have the heavenly view.
Nga ayagala obere mu mbala eyeggulu.
So that's why you start realizing the things of heaven.
Yensonga lwaki otandika okulaba ebintu by'eggulu.
But before you do that,
n'ate nga tonnaba kukola ekyo,
you must lose the love for the earthly.
Oyina okusuula okwagala okw'ensi.
Now, that's where we find the biggest challenge for the prophet. That the people, or maybe the Christians, do not want to lose the earthly love. But they want to continue being earthly, but also be like heavenly. Now, you cannot get pointed to the vision of God.
Kati gwa tukasobola kutunuza mu plan za Katonda.
So it will be very hard for God now to start making you the person you want.
Kati atawo kija kubera Katonda kizibu nyo kufula omuntu gwayagala obere.
In fact, the earthly people, maybe the Christians now, this modern Christianity.
Kati abantu b'ensi naddala balo abalokola b'ennaku zino.
Yeah, the modern ones, Not the older ones, but this modern ones.
Tugamba bali abakadde, tugamba bano aba .com ab'ennaku zino.
Yeah, the .com Christians,
Bano abalokola b'ennaku zino.
They want to enforce the temple to be eternal.
Bagala okukaka ebintu byabwe ebyenso okufuuka ebyoluberera.
Yeah, like they want their earthly ones to be eternal.
Bagala embala zaabwe ezensi zibere ezoluberera.
And also be like heavenly.
Ate neera bagala okubeera ng'abantu ab'eggulu.
Now, that is not the mandate of the prophetic ministry.
Kati ate ekyo si kye kiruubirirwa ky'obuweereza obw'omunnabbi.
The prophetic ministry mandate is not to make the temple become heavenly. No.
Ekiruubirirwa ky'obuweereza bw'obunnabbi si kye kukwata bino ebiggwaawo ate babifuule eby'eggulu.
No. Its mandate is to bring the heavenly bare on earth.
Ekiruubirirwa ky'obuweereza bw'obunnabbi kwe kuleeta eby'eggulu bibeere ku nsi.
With a view of transforming the earthly.
Ate nga kirina n'omulamwa okukyusa eby'ensi.
It does not come only to bear but also to transform.
Tebijja buzijja si kubeera ku nsi nate n'okukyusa eby'ensi.
But also to enforce eternal authority.
Ate n'okakasa nti nno obuyinza obutagwerawo. Obuyinza obw'olubeerera nabwo bubeerawo.
Prophetic ministry.
Kambabule awabeera obuweereza bw'obunnabbi.
The eternal authority is enforced.
Obuyinza obutaggwaawo bubeerawo bukakibwawo.
And that's why you're able to see things that bear in heaven and here on earth. You're able to see.
Y'ensonga lwaki osobola okulaba ebintu ebyo mu ggulu wano ku nsi.
I know when I hear people say behind, I saw.
Njala okuwulira abantu nga bagamba ebyo bega nti nze nalabye.
The angel with the sword.
Naye malayika n'ekiso n'ekitala.
That one is witnessing to the prophetic.
Ekyo kiriko kijulira ekigendererwa ky'obunnabbi.
That trying to enforce the eternal authority to bear on earth.
Nga chiriko chikaka obuyinza obutagwawo okubeera ku nsi.
It does not show that you are the one who is important. No.
Tekiraga nti ye gw'owa omugaso ennyo nnyona edda.
No, it is witnessing to the prophetic mandate.
Chiriko chijulira okigendera ky'obuweereza obw'obunnabbi.
Now the problem is that the people who see misunderstand.
Kati ekizibu ekiriwo kiri nti bano abalaba tebategeera bulungi kigendererwa ky'obuweereza bw'obunnabbi.
Now they become more important than the prophetic mandate.
Kati bo batandika okuwulira bo nga ba mugaso nnyo nnyo okusinga ekigendererwa ky'obunnabbi.
So you see how I saw this
thing. Kati loza mulaba yenzaala babinonze eyabiraba.
Now they start being more important than the mandate.
Kati bo muli batandika okuwulira bo nga ba mugaso nnyo nnyo okusinga ekigendererwa ky'obunnabbi.
Those things that God is showing is trying to show you that you are in a true place.
Ebintu ebyo Katonda byaliko byalaga biraga nti oli mu kifo ekituufu era n'omulimu gwe guliko okuleeta wano obuyinza obutaggwaawo nga bubika buno obuyinza obuggwa era nga kiraga nti n'obuliko bukola gwe oliwo nga mujulirwa ku kigendererwa ky'obunnabbi. Kati wano ewali obuzibu nti ate bw'ogezaako okukola omugugu gw'obunnabbi
without losing the earthly love,
nga tosoose kusuula okwagala kw'ensi,
without losing our identity,
nga tosoose okusuula ebyennono gwe n'ebikufuula ky'oli.
Now the prophetic burden, or maybe the prophetic office,
kati eno yafeesi y'obunnabbi oba omugugu gw'obunnabbi
gets overpowered and subverted,
gukufuukira omunene ogw'amaanyi
affirm its own ways.
Ate ne gukomekereza nga gutaddewo engeri zaagwo.
You understand the execution.
Ndowooza mutegeera engeri gye tubiteeka mu nkola.
Now for now we shall stop here.
Ndowooza leero tujja kukoma wano.
We have looked at the background and then we are looking at the prophetic mandate. We are going to understand actually this prophetic mandate.
Ndowooza tutunuuliddeko engeri obuweereza obw'obunnabbi gye buli, entandika yaabwo.
Because of time is
kurakadde,
we shall maybe add on next time.
Tugenda kumawa tujja kutandika okuddako.
And believe we still have a lot in plenty.
Era nzikiriza nno tulina bingi.
May God bless you. Unless if you have any question,
Katonda wawe omukisa okuleka nga olina ekibuuzo nga natwala bibiri byokka.
Him and everything we pray.
Aza muyimirire tusabe.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Kitafa ali mukuru muri nya Yesu Kristo.
Want to thank you Father for today.
Twagala okwebaza ku lwa leero.
We thank you Father for the beginning of this prophetic ministry.
Twagala okwebaza ku entandika y'omuto guno ogw'obuweereza ogw'obunnabbi.
Father, we know that it is you that can make us understand.
Tukimanyi nti naye gwe asobola okutuleetera okitegeera.
Father, we pray that even the words we have heard,
tusaba nti n'ebigambo bye tuwulidde,
shall go into our hearts.
Leka bigende mu mitima gyaffe.
Meditate upon them.
Leka tubirowooze.
Contemplate on them.
Leka tubirowoolezeeko ddala ebuziba.
Until we are able, Father, to conceive your word.
Paka we tunaategeera okukifuna ne kinyikira mu ffe.
Father, may you enable us.
Katonda wange tusobozese.
May you uplift us.
Leka otuyimuse.
May you continue to open our hearts.
Leka weyongere okugula emitima gyaffe.
And Father, bless us continually with your word.
Era Katonda weyongere otuwa omukisa n'ekigambo kyo.
And let this word continue to grow in our hearts.
Era leka ekigambo kyo kyeyongere okula emitima gyaffe.
And let it bear fruit.
Era leka kibere.
Father, it's my prayer also that your children shall understand, they shall cultivate knowledge, so that they can be never be pushed by the wind that comes from every side. Let be this word be affirmation,
leka ekigambo kino kibeere omusingi,
and also a foundation,
leka kubeere omusingi n'okakasibwa,
to understand the true Christ,
okutegeera Yesu Kristo omutuufu,
to understand the prophetic ministry,
okutegeera obuweereza obw'obunnabbi,
and understand the true God,
era n'okutegeera Katonda omutuufu.
We thank you, glorify you,
tukwebaza era tukugulumiza,
in Jesus' name we pray.
Mu linnya lya Yesu Kristo tusabye. Katonda wawe omukisa.